Yes.
So I'm curious what you think about the other type of singularity, that is the Kurzweilian technological.
Okay, you said this is the last question. Okay. So this better be an awesome question, because this is the last question.
Will we transcend our humanism in this century, as some think we will?
You're talking about Kurzweil's singularity, where the computing power is rising at such a rate, and the storage power. He is suggesting that there will come a day where every thought that the human brain is capable of can be uploaded into a computer, thereby transferring your very existence, your essence, every thought you never had or will have, into the computer, because the computer made a perfect neurosynaptic model of your brain. And so you want to know, will the world change as much as he says it will? Okay. I'm not convinced, because machines have bested us many times before. Machines can plow better than any animal can. We make machines that outperform us. We're not saying, oh my gosh, what am I going to do? No, we don't go through some existential crisis every time this happens. Our machines now beat us in chess. Our machines do calculations faster and better and more reliable than us. Our machines fly our airplanes for us. Our machines land the airplanes. Our machines stabilize the airplanes. Our machines are so much better than us, and we're cool with that. Right? So you say now your brain is on a computer? By the way, I don't think a computer can actually capture your brain, because a computer makes logical steps. In order for a computer to imitate the human, you'd have to, like, mess with it. All right? There's your whole brain there, and then you'd have to, like, shock it. You have to do something. I think that's the source of our art. Think about it. If we were all entirely rational, you would never have painted Starry Night. You would have never composed the late quartets of Beethoven, the late string quartets. There are works of art out there that could not have possibly come from the mind of a rational person, right? That they came from something deep within, where the person felt what they created. Someone asked me, what do I think of Bangalore Starry Night? You know, the picture with the big old vibrating stars, and I said, I'm struck by it. They're worried that I'm criticizing, because it's not real. And I said, it doesn't have to be objectively real. As art, it only needs to be subjectively real. And not only that, I don't want it to come all the way to tell me what is happening, because then it doesn't leave me any place to stand to personalize what I'm looking at. For me, the best art that's out there allows me to walk up to it and allows me to take possession of its meaning. And when I do that, the art becomes part of me, not something separate from me. And so when I look at Starry Night, I said, I don't know what he saw, but that's how he felt. I think we're farther away than Kurzweil suggests about computers saying, I don't feel that way. I feel this other way. I'm just not convinced. It makes a nice cult, sort of intellectual, philosophical cult. But I'm otherwise not convinced. And the day, even if it does happen, we'll celebrate it and find something else to do. Right? Go play golf or something, you know? I don't think computers figured that one out yet. All of you, thank you so much for your love.